At Solace, our treatment programs are all customized to specific needs of each individual. And studies have shown us that a daily structure is an essential part of starting the recovery process. So we start our day here at 8 a.m. with breakfast. During breakfast, we make sure that meals are done in a community setting. So clients get to sit together, eat together, and discuss how they feel. Then after that, there is a check-in where they share their emotions or the frustrations about the day before or the events that have taken place throughout the day. We have our recovery coaches and counselors sit in during these check-ins and try and process what's coming out of them. This information is essential for us because it's taken into our clinical meetings later at 8:30 or 9 a.m. in the morning. The clinical team uses each client's feedback and client from each clinician to discuss how to customize the approach further during that day. So once the check-in session is over, the next group would be a self-reflection group, or maybe an interpersonal group, or even sometimes a psychoeducational group. Again, this is facilitated by the clinical team, either the psychologists, the counselors, or sometimes by one of the recovery coaches themselves. The topic for the day is normally decided based on what comes up. We, of course, have a structured program where it reflects each day's topic. But sometimes, as you know, people change throughout the day, and we have to be fluid enough to change our goals as well based on what's surfacing coming out of the clients. So the morning check-in is very important. We start the next group. During this group, sometimes it's psychoeducational, sometimes it's lessons, sometimes it's teaching. The clients get a chance to talk about things that have been bothering them, things that have been disturbing them in their lives. And this is addressed in a group setting. We have found that group sessions seem to be very intense sometimes and can be very productive if it's facilitated the right way. And that's where the expertise of our clinicians come into play. We need specialists who are addiction trained and also clinically certified to be able to do this. By the time the group is over, everyone's tired and they need a break. Then comes lunch. Meals are an important part of the whole structure as well. Now we note that in early recovery, many people tend to build an appetite. They start to eat more and the craving for food goes up. Sweet things, carbohydrates. These are some of the things that they may have neglected during the active addictions or substance misuse period. So in recovery, especially during the early period, we make sure that they get the right nutrition and they're not overfed. So our chef, who's a very trained and experienced chef, the chefs will work with the counselors, with the clinical team, with each client to decide what may not be good and what may not be the best choice of food. So food is a la carte. We have tried buffet food, we have tried a la carte food, and we find that sometimes a la carte works better for certain groups of people. Sometimes buffet works better for certain groups of people. So food is also customized to specific needs of each client. During meals, we make sure that the clients are not left alone. So we have our recovery coaches who sit in with them, talk to them, and explain to them that eating is an important part of this whole process of recovery, where you get to talk and discuss and share part of the whole interpersonal and sharing process. Now, after meals, clients get a break. That's when they go for their own personal time, some time to read, some like to go out to their rooms to get a siesta, and some of them like to just check on their homework, the assignments, and meet up with the counselors. Second half of the day, each client is assigned his own individual clinician, case manager, counselor, or a psychologist. So each client gets one clinician to work with. The clinicians are decided based upon, again, the evaluations and assessments that we do at the intake or pre-admission period, where we decide which counselor may work best based on personality, based on assessments, based on feedback from the family, based on upbringing. A lot of factors that we need to look into before we decide how this therapeutic relationship will work best. So once the meal's over, clients get to see their clinicians or their counselors, and that's where they sit down and do the intensive one-on-one work. It sounds like a heavy day with lots of clinical work. So very often we give them a break and we go into alternative therapies in the afternoon. Music therapy, art therapy, yoga, gym, swimming. These are some of the choices the client get to do in the afternoons. Each activity again needs to be beneficial for the client. Not everyone benefits from strenuous physical activity. Sometimes they need something less strenuous. So some mental exercises, playing a board of chess, for example, a game of chess, stimulating the brain. So even activities need to be decided based on specific needs as well. This goes on throughout the afternoon mostly. Sometimes in the afternoon, some of the clients have to meet their doctors or their psychiatrists. Some of them may have appointments with hospitals or clinics outside as well. So this happens also in the afternoons. We try and plan it so they get a break and they go out to see the doctors and come back. Once this is done, it's probably about 5 o'clock and everyone takes a break. An important event, 6 p.m. dinner. It's a community setting. People eat together again. The meals are selected and approved by the clinical team at least 2 days before each meal is presented to the client. Every evening, once dinner is done, and once they have another check-in or a check-out, rather. Check-ins in the morning and then we have our check-outs in the evening. The next thing would be a group to end the day. Sometimes it's an anonymous group. It could be a 12-step group, Alcoholics Anonymous, Narcotics Anonymous, or Gamblers Anonymous, depending on the presentations of the group or the clients themselves. And once the group meeting is done, by the time it's maybe about 8:30 or 9, clients are given a break and they're allowed to go back to their rooms, call loved ones, call family members, and the day ends. So you see, it's never a boring day in Solace. Neither is it for the clinicians or for the clients, because every activity, every event, even eating is planned according to specific needs and it's structured to be a clinically therapeutic activity. Thank you.